Let us continue the slides now. I think the last solution video has not completed properly. So I'm going to play the video once again. Just listen.
Next, we are going to represent root of 8.5 and root of 9.5 on the number line. So for that, take the first one, root of 8.5. So first we are going to draw a line with the length 8.5 centimeter. Let us take the end points as A and B. So next, just extend the line AB into one unit. That is, let us take this as 1 centimeter. Right? So let us take this one as C. Right? Then after that, now we are going to bisect AC. So how can you bisect a number, that is number line or any line? How can you bisect? So with your compass. So take your compass and make AC center. And take more than half of AC, so not more than half of AB, more than half of AC, and then draw one arc above and below the line. Right? In a similar way, keep the same measurement and make C as a center and draw one more arc so that will intersect the previous arc. So if not intersect, I mean just extend the arc that will intersect. Then after that, draw the line through this. Just draw the line through this. Actually, here I've drawn roughly, so you can use your exact measurement. Okay, and this intersection point, let us take this as O, and then again take your compass and make O as a center and O as a radius. Just to draw a semicircle from A, so that will pass through definitely C. Alright, then after that. From B, so draw a vertical line with a 90 degree exactly, make over a protractor, right? So this intersection point is nothing but D. Then after that, again take your compass, make B as a center and measure BD as a radius. So draw one more arc, so that will intersect here. So extend the line little more. So this will be intersecting here. This intersection point is nothing but your root of 8.5, and this length also is nothing but root of 8.5. So that is the procedure to represent the decimal numbers with the square root on the number line, right?
Have you seen the video, students? I think you understood how to draw how to represent the real numbers on the number line. And one more question also I gave, that is root of 9.2. Just try it as a homework, right? So next, the section is nothing but exponents, right? So exponents already know that. Already in our lower sections, you have seen about the exponential formula, basic formulas, right? So first one, a power m into a power n equal to a power m plus n. And this is the second one. And this is the third one. This is the fourth one. And this is the fifth one. And this is the sixth one. So six basic formulas are available in exponents. So with the help of these formulas, we have to simplify the given exponential questions, right? So look at the formulas here. That is, six formulas are available here. So here the formula is important. Other than that, the concept is very, very important. Okay, what is the concept? So every formula says one concept. Okay, so the first formula is nothing but look at the base, both are same, and look at the power, they are different. So if the given question contains same base, and no need to bother about the powers, the powers may be different or equal, right? If the given in the given question the base are same, so in product we have to add the power, right? That is a power m plus n. In the similar way, in second formula, if base are same, but in division, we have to subtract the power. We have to subtract the denominator power from the numerator power. That is a power m minus n. That is a concept. And look at here, base are different, but powers are same. So base are different and powers are same means in multiplication. So we have to multiply the base first and then apply the common power, right? And the same thing here, division. The bases are different and powers are same. So first we should divide the base and apply the common power. And here this formula shows that if a base having more than one power, that is more than one power, it may be 2 powers or 3 powers, even 10 powers, whatever it is, we should multiply the powers. That's it. So write the same base and multiply the power. That is the concept here. And here a power 0 equal to 1. So if a base having 0 in its power, the value is nothing but 1. The base, whatever it is, that is 1000 power 0, 10,000 power 0, even 1 lakh power 0, the value is nothing but 1 only. So if the base are same, means we should add the power. That is the first one. And second one, base are same, and if we divide them, we should subtract the power. And next one, if base are different and powers are same, means we should multiply the power if the multiplication symbol is there. So multiply the base and apply the same power, that is common power. And the same thing for division. If the base are different and powers are same, means divide the base first and apply the common power. And here any base contains 2 or more powers, so multiply the powers and write the base as it is. And anything power 0 is nothing but 1. So these are the basic exponential formulas, right? So look at the example now. So simplify the following. So these are the questions now. So 6 subdivisions are there. So everything having the exponential, that is powers. So we are going to simplify them, right, with the help of the formula. So let us see that in the solution video now. And similarly here, the first subdivision, 21 power 2 by 3 is there. It is not a 21, I printed wrongly. That is here 2 power 2 by 3, that is a minimum. So 2 power 2 by 3 into 2 power 1 by 3, right? So look at the solution video now.
Look at the solution now. So the first subdivision is 2 power 2 by 3 into 2 to the power 1 by 3. So look at the base, both are same. If the base are same and they are in multiplication, it is enough to use the rule a power m into a power n. So that a to the power m plus n. So base are same means we should add the power, right? So equal to 2 to the power 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3. So the powers both are rational numbers, so we can add directly. So 2 to the power 3 by 3, so equal to 2 to the power 1 equal to 2. So that is the answer for the first one. And second subdivision, 7 power 1 by 5 divided by 7 to the power 1 by 3. So look at the denominator, that is base. So base are same and they are in division. So base are same, they are in division, means which rule we have to use? A power m by a power n equal to a to the power m minus n. That is, we are going to subtract the powers. So this can be written as 7 power 1 by 5 minus 1 by 3. Look at the power, they are rational numbers. So subtraction of one rational from the another. How can we subtract it? So look at the denominator, they are different. So we are going to take LCM or cross multiplication. Right? So make cross multiplication. So 3 into 1, 3 minus 5 into 1, 5, and 5 3 is 15. So we can deal with LCM also. The same answer only will get. So equal to 7 to the power minus 2 divided by 15. So that is the answer for the second one. And third one, 13 power 1 by 5 into 17 power 1 by 5. So here look at the base, both are different, and look at the power, both are same. So different base and same power means which rule you have to use? That is a power m into b power m. That means they are in product also, so multiply them and apply this same power. So here also we are going to multiply 13 into 17 and we are going to take the common power 1 by 5. So equal to, so 13 into 17, 221 power 1 by 5. So that is your answer for the third one. And next fourth one, 64 power 1 by 2. So look at the base, only one base is there. So only one base is there means we are going to factorize the base according to the denominator of the power. So here denominator of the power is nothing but 2. So we are going to factor 64 with the power of 2. How can we write? So look at here. So 64, so 8 8s are 64. So 64 can be write as 8 square. So 8 square power 1 by 2. Actually, we can factor 64 in any other way. But look at the power. So according to that, only you are going to factor the base. Why? Because so they will both are same, and also one base having more than one power means we should multiply the powers so that these two get cancelled each other. So for this purpose only we have to write like this. Okay. So equal to 8 power 1 equal to 8. That is the answer. And fifth substitution, 125 power 1 by 3. Here also only one number is there. We are going to factorize that base with the power 3 because the denominator of the power is 3. That's why. So how can you write 25 to the power of 3? 5 power 3. And this 3. So equal to 5 into 3 into 1 by 3. 3 3 get cancelled. So 5 power 1 equal to 5. At last, 6th one. So 9 power 3 by 2 equal to. So here also only one number is there. So we are going to factors base with the power 2 because the denominator of the power is 2. So 9 can be written as 3 square. So power 3 by 2. So equal to 3 power 2 into 3 by 2. So 2 to get cancelled equal to 3 to the power 3. So 3 power 3 is nothing but we are going to multiply 3 3 times. So 27. So that will be the answer.
So have you seen the video, students? I think you all understood how to simplify the exponents by the help of the exponential formula. Right. So next example, listen here. From the following, check which are rational and which are irrational. Right? We are going to check which type of numbers are rational and irrational. Already you know that about rational and irrational numbers, right? So look at the number 0.125 bar. So how can you exclude this one? So 0.125555 keep going on because the bar above 5. So it is comes under what type of decimal expansion? So non-terminating recurring, that is repeating. So this kind of decimal expansion corresponds to which number? Rational. So it is nothing but rational. And look at the next example. Say 3.125, 1250, 1250. Here anything repeated here? So here non-terminated, that is the first case. And second case, is it anything repeated? No. So 125, 1250, 1250. So different set of numbers. So here non-terminating as well as non-recurring, that is non-repeating. So it is comes under irrational numbers. And look at the third one, root of 64. So 64, is it a square number or not? Yes, square number. So the square root of 64 is nothing but 8. So 8 is an irrational number. Sorry, 8 is a rational number. Therefore, it is rational. So don't say the numbers having the square root that is an irrational number. Not like that. We have to analyze that. Okay. So here also root is there, but it is not a rational number because 64 is a square number. So 8 is the square root of that number. So that's why it is rational. And look at the next one, 2.58962. So it is a terminated one. So terminated means definitely will be a rational number, right? So next one, root of 5. So root of 5, if you find out the square root of this number, means keep going on and won't stop anyway. And also that the same set of numbers not repeating. So this is nothing but irrational number, right? So that is the way of checking whether the given number is a rational or irrational with the help of the decimal expansion, right? So what we have seen from the last class itself, so finding the rational number between the two rational numbers and finding sufficient number of rational numbers between two rational numbers and finding decimal numbers into the form of p by q, and next representation of irrational numbers on the number line and representation of real numbers on the number line. And we have seen operations among the irrational numbers today. So, and rationalize the denominator of the rational numbers by multiplying with the conjugates and simplification of exponents. So, this kind of topics, everything there in our first lesson, and that lesson got over now. Right? So, just go through the video once again and go through each questions and each videos And if you have any doubt, just ask me. Thank you.